Welcome to Frederick County Public Library's virtual programming. My name is Miss Kristen, and today is Preschool Storytime. Today's story time is all about the days of the week. Do any of you know how many days there are in a week?
Seven.
That's right. There are 7 days in a week. Could you show me 7 fingers? Let's count them out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 days in a week. Let's practice saying our 7 days. We start with Sunday. After Sunday comes Monday. Next we have Tuesday. After Tuesday comes Wednesday. Then we have Thursday, followed by Friday. And we end with Saturday. Great job, friends. Depending on the day of the week, you might wear different clothes, go different places, or do different activities. Let's read about a kid named Riley and see what Riley feels like wearing during the week. What Riley Wore, written by Alana K. Arnold and illustrated by Linda Davick. And we would like to say a special thank you to Beach Lane Books, an imprint of Simon & Schuster, for allowing us to read this story. On Monday, Riley wore a bunny costume because it was the first day of school and Riley felt shy. It was true that no one else in class wore a bunny costume. But it was also true that a girl who was crying asked if she could touch one of the ears. Riley said yes. The ears feel just like real velvet. On Tuesday, Riley wore a superhero cape to the dentist office because teeth cleaning is scary and Riley wanted to be brave. The dentist asked, "What's your superpower?" Riley said, "I'll have to get back to you on that." On Wednesday, Riley wore a ball gown out to dinner with Otto and Oma because they went to a fancy restaurant and ball gowns are the fanciest. When Riley spilled tomato soup, Oma used ginger ale to blot it out. A kid at another table said they should leave the stain just as it was because it looked like a star and stars are cool. Thursday was Universe Day at school, so Riley decided that outer space jammies were the perfect thing to wear. Riley's teacher loved the jammies and he asked Riley to stand on a chair while he pointed out the planets on Riley's back. Then everyone used scissors and glue and construction paper and made planets of their own. It rained on Friday, so Riley wore a colorful combination of rubber boots, a police officer jacket, and the world's best tutu. The crossing guard told Riley, "I had a pair of rain boots just like that when I was little." The recess captain, a big kid in the sixth grade, told Riley, "I like your tutu." When the weather turned mild on Saturday, Riley dressed in a hard hat and overalls to help her dad run errands. 3 guys at the hardware store called Riley Daddy's Little Helper, and one of them gave Riley a sticker. Riley didn't peel it away from its backing because maybe it would be a good present for a friend someday. When they got home, Riley tucked the sticker away for safekeeping and wondered if being a friend could be a superpower. Sunday was a lazy home day. Riley spent part of it wearing nothing at all. But when Mom asked who wanted to go to the park, Riley put on 1 striped sock and 1 polka-dotted sock. Purple jeans, the world's best tutu, a crazy monster shirt, red rubber boots, round aviator goggles, and a hat with dinosaur spikes. At the park, Riley felt shy. Then a kid from school walked up and asked, "Are you a girl or a boy?" Riley said, Today, I'm a firefighter and a dancer and a monster hunter and a pilot and a dinosaur. Oh, said the kid, want to play? Yes! Then Riley reached into a pocket, pulled out the sticker, and gave it to the kid. The kid smiled. And Riley felt wonderful. The end. While I have the world's best tutu on, let's dance along to the song I'm Gonna Catch You by Lori Bertner. Thank you, Ms. Bertner, for allowing us to use your wonderful music. And friends, be sure to listen for the days of the week while we dance. Predictable order that repeats. When we say the days of the week, we start on Sunday and continue on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then we repeat them. Patterns help us to understand how the world works. Let's read a story about patterns. Pitter Patterin by Joyce Hesselberth.
And a special thank you to Green Willow Books, an imprint of HarperCollins Publishers, for allowing us to read this story. Pitter, pitter, pat. Pitter, pitter, pat. Pitter, pitter-pat. Hey, it's a pitter-pitter-patterin. Lou helps her friends take off their wet things. Boot, boot, puddle. Boot, boot, puddle. Another pattern. What comes next?
Boot, boot, puddle.
Milk, apple, cracker, cheese. Milk, apple, cracker, cheese. Milk, apple, cracker, cheese. There are patterns everywhere. How many can you find?
I see apple, apple, pear, apple, pear, apple, pear, apple, pear.
I see flowers in a pattern in a vase, also in a pattern.
After snack time, Lou says goodbye to her friends. She'll see them again next Sunday. Next Sunday? Hey, the days of the week are a pattern too. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then it starts again. Monday. Lou has soccer practice after school on Monday. She and her teammates practice kicking the ball between the cones. In, out, in, out, in, out. Soccer balls are made of black and white shapes that fit together. These shapes curve around the entire ball. Tuesday. On Tuesday, Lou goes to her piano lesson. Hey, look at the piano keys. Two black keys, three black keys. Two black keys, three black keys. All the way up the keyboard. The notes on the white keys are a pattern too. Lou claps her hands together to learn the rhythm of the song. Ta ti ti ta. Ta ti ti ta. Music is full of patterns. Wednesday. In dance class, the beat of the drum is a pattern. Boom ba ba boom. Boom ba ba boom. And the steps in Lou's dance make a pattern.
Jump, hop, kick, twirl. Jump, hop, kick, twirl. Jump, hop, kick, twirl. Jump, hop, kick, twirl.
Thursday. What a nice day. Lou and her dad go for a walk in the park. Are there patterns here?
I see flower petals.
I see the tree wing.
And here?
I see the water circles.
I see purple stripes on her pants.
Friday. Lou spends Friday night with her grandma. They curl up in quilts and read a story. The patterns in the quilts all have names. Evening star, pinwheels, attic windows, and Lou's favorite, flying geese. When the story is over, it's time for bed. It's hard to fall asleep. Counting sheep might help. White sheep, black sheep. White sheep, oh, white sheep, oh, black sheep. Saturday. The next morning, Lou and her grandma ride the bus to the zoo. Are there patterns here?
I see the zebra's black and white stripes.
I see the giraffes.
And here?
I see the fish making the pattern.
I see a penguin and ice cream.
Lou loves all the animals she saw today. She can't wait to tell her friends about them on Sunday. Sunday, pitter, pitter, pat. Pitter, pitter, pat. Pitter, pitter, pat. The end.
Patterns are all around us. Take some time today to look around your house, or maybe while you're out on a walk, look for the patterns that surround you. Friends, there are so many great books about the days of the week, and our last story today is based on the book The Big Five, written by Bella Macatini and illustrated by Judy Abbott. Will you help me try to guess the five most famous animals of Africa and then act them out? Okay, here we go.
Danny is staying with his grandpa for 5 days. He loves to look at grandpa's painting of five animals in Africa. Those are the big five, the five most famous animals in my homeland, says grandpa. Why don't I tell you about one each day? On Monday, grandpa gives Danny the first clue. The first animal is so big that you can see him from a great distance. He has big ears, big tusks, and a long trunk. Do you know what animal that is? Very good. Do you know what an elephant is good at? Stomping. Be an elephant and stomp around the room. On Tuesday, Grandpa gives the second clue. The second animal roars so loud that you can hear him from a distance. He has a long mane, sharp teeth, and dangerous claws. Do you know what animal that is? Very good. Do you know what the lion is good at? Jumping. Be a lion and jump around the room. On Wednesday, Grandpa gives the third clue. The third animal has thick skin and two horns on his nose. Do you know what it is? Very good. What is a rhino good at? Grazing. Pretend to graze and eat on your hands and knees. On Thursday, Grandpa tells Danny about the fourth animal. The fourth animal looks like a big cat, has soft fur, and is covered with spots. Do you know what animal that is?
Leopard. Leopard.
Very good. Do you know what a leopard is good at? Climbing. Pretend to climb a ladder or a tree. Friday is the last day, and Grandpa gives the last clue. The fifth animal has two crooked horns above his ear and likes to be with friends. Danny doesn't know what that animal is. Do you? It's a buffalo. A buffalo is also good at running. Run in place. That night, Grandpa surprises Danny by giving him the painting of the Big Five. You may take this painting home with you, and when you're bigger, we'll visit the land where I come from. Thank you, Grandpa. I can't wait.
And now it's time for ASL with Miss Julia.
Hi there. I'm Miss Julia, and I'm with the Edward F. Fry Memorial Library in Point of Rocks. Today, I'm going to be giving an ASL lesson in the days of the week. That's right. The calendar still trudges along in spite of the pandemic. So I'm going to teach you different signs about the days of the week, Sunday through Saturday. I will also be teaching you the sign for day, week, and even the number sign for seven, because there are 7 days in a week. So we'll go ahead and start with the word day, or the sign for day. So you take your non-dominant hand, arm out like this. Actually, it would be lower normally, but because of my computer, I'm keeping it up here. And you put your elbow right where your fingers are, and it's like this, day. Just bring your hand down. Let me see if I can do it this way. So if you want to say day, arm out, dominant elbow on top of the fingers, and make sure you have your index finger extended. Day. Day. Okay. And then the sign for week, take your non-dominant hand, knuckles out, palm facing you, index finger on your dominant hand, week. Week. And if you want to ask how many days in a week there are, you'd say, how many days in a week? How many? And the response would be 7. So take your dominant hand, and you're going to use your thumb and ring finger for this. 7. 7. 7. Like that. 7 days in a week. Okay. So first we're going to start with Monday, everyone's favorite day. So you're going to actually use a lot of hand shapes with these signs. You ready? So dominant hand, you're going to make the hand shape for the letter M. So the letter M is your thumb folded across. You can touch your pinky. And then those middle fingers come down. This is an M. Okay. This would be N. And as in Nancy, we don't want that. It's got to be the 3 fingers. These 3 for the letter M. And then you're going to twist it back around. Send Monday. Monday. Okay. 3 fingers down. Monday. Now there's a sign for Tuesday. Dominant hand up. Thumb in between your index and middle fingers for T. This is the hand shape for the letter T. And then you're going to twist it back around, Tuesday. So far we've had Monday and now Tuesday, okay? You don't have to, when you're signing these days, you don't, you know, show them that you're making an M or show them make it, you're making a T. You just Monday, Tuesday, like that. The next sign is Wednesday. You're going to make a W, which is 3 fingers up. Your thumb and your pinky touching, spin it around, Wednesday, Wednesday. Okay. And now Thursday is a little tricky because if we go by the same rules we've had, it would be a T, right? No, because we already have that for Tuesday. For Thursday, we're going to go by its second letter, H. So H is your dominant hand, knuckles out, index and middle finger extended, Thursday, Thursday. So far we've learned Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And next is Friday. Now Friday, we go back to the pattern, make an F. So dominant hand, bring your index and thumb together. So these 3 are sticking up, Friday. Friday. Okay. Let's review those again. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Very good. And now the weekend. We have Saturday and Sunday. So Saturday is an S. So your dominant hand, these 4 fingers folded down and your thumb across. That's the S. That's the hand shape for the letter S. Bring it around, Saturday. And then Sunday is very easy. Both hands, thumbs out like this, your fingers together, Sunday. 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 Like that. Okay. One more time. Okay. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. All right. Thank you so much, friends, for joining me. This has been ASL with Miss Julia.
Thank you for joining us today for Preschool Storytime. If you would like to read more about the days of the week, here are some titles that you can check out through curbside pickup. Bye-bye.